Hello, my love bugs. Welcome back. Yes, we are here with another dating type video in this new year. So I kind of wanted to do a recap of 2023 dating topics that I did, just so you all have a bit of a reminder and a refresher in regards to actively dating. All right. So welcome back, my loves. I thank you so much for joining me always. So today, I just want you all to really focus on being more aware, having more dating awareness when you're trying to actively date and just kind of put yourself out there. So here are eight, I believe, of the topics that I wanted to just to touch on real quick with you as a refresher so that you can have a more successful dating experience this year, or a less disappointing one. Whichever way it goes, it is going to be beneficial. So number one, we need to firstly know ourselves. You have done the necessary introspection, doing some self-reflecting to determine what it is you need from someone. Okay. And when we speak about needs, I'm talking relatively towards your emotional desires, what you expect from someone emotionally. Okay. In that aspect, because when we talk about just basic needs, well, you can kind of get that from anywhere, but you want to know if this person will be able to reciprocate. All right. As much as you're giving it, reciprocate. So basically knowing each other's love languages. So this is why it is imperative to know yourself and know what it is that you need from someone so that you don't go in search of and then end up being just even more disappointed. Next, you need to be certain that you have a dating preference. What are you looking for when it comes to dating? I mean, you just can't go on a date with someone, agree to show up and not know what your intentions are. That's senseless. Because I guarantee you, if you ask them, they say, well, I actively date. Now, if you are someone who's dating with a purpose and intentions for something more serious, perhaps a commitment, in the next, year, you're looking for that monogamy, well, then that may not be the person you want to be with. So this is why you need to know what your preference of dating is during that time. Are you actively dating? Or are you looking for a relationship? What are you doing? Okay, so you definitely need to know that. This way you're not misled, you're not misleading the other person, and there's no, confusion in regards to what it is that you're looking for. Next, once you determine what it is that you are in search of or what you're trying to do, so let's say, for example, you are looking for something more serious. You want to date maybe the same person just for a period of time until you actually can agree to be, committed. Sweetie, if you don't do anything else in this world, you must and you should always, in any regard, create boundaries. Create them and then maintain them. So if you have not done that from last year, when you got out of that last situation, or you've had your previous disappointing dating experience, know, my love, before going forward, you need to create boundaries. I will not allow this. Okay, I'll accept this and maybe tolerate that, but I definitely will not allow this. Okay, so you need to have some lines drawn throughout and stand firmly on them. Do not deviate, because when you deviate, giving someone the benefit of the doubt, that's when you usually end up disappointed. No, stand firmly and let them conform to what it is that you believe in and your integrity. Okay, so you want to have some morals and integrity in these dating experiences. Otherwise, you're going to end up on the other side. Okay, and that's not a good look. Next. You want to be able to probe. And I think I talked about that in my very last video, I believe. Probing, asking questions that that transition into other questions that give you more answers. Being aware of the red flags. And they may not even necessarily be red flags, but may just be something that you may not be willing to deal with, to tolerate. Okay? Again, creating boundaries, you know that. So you know if you see a red flag, what does a red flag mean? It doesn't mean stay and try to work through it and hopes that this person is going to change. No, that's not what it means. Red flags mean get the hell out of there. Or just consider this person, you know, someone you just hang out with every now and then. Nothing serious. We don't have to be mean towards people, you know, but you may not want to date someone with a serious track record, or they've been to jail or prison a few times. You may not want that. It may not be a red flag for some people, but it may not be a preference for you. You understand what I'm saying? So just, you kind of want it to make sense. All right. Now, once you've done all of that, what we have to stop doing, my loves, I don't care how someone comes off as, you know, trusting, and they seem as though they are legit and they're cool. No. We are in 2024 now. Trust must be earned. Allow me to repeat that for all of those in the back. Trust must always be earned by everyone. Okay? You just can't assume that someone is. There are a lot of wolves out there in sheep's clothing. So, and with that, when you take a person through that process, it is going to be lengthy and it's going to allow you to see a lot of goodness in them, or a mixed batch. And then you can differentiate the things that you can tolerate and maybe not even want to deal with at all. Okay? So any individual, regardless if you're dating or not, allow their trust in you. They have to earn it, period. And you should expect the same. If someone is letting you in wholly, just like, oh, come on into my world. Just come on. Be leery of that. That could backfire. May not be anything that is, you know, devious, but you may not be able to get rid of them. I've had that. All right. They may be so sweet and kind. Before you know it, they're knocking on your door. They're blowing your phone up. They're everywhere. And you can't get rid of them, even though they're a sweetheart. Or at least they seem. You understand what I'm saying? So, yeah, definitely allow that trust to be earned, which allows you to have to take your time. Okay, so it's beneficial either way it goes. Next, I think one video I talked about consistency. Okay, so people say consistency is a great thing. It is, in certain aspects. But when it's just a consistency of no motion, very little forward movement, you know, that person and yourself may communicate throughout the day. You may go out and hang out or whatever, but it's not going anywhere. It's like jogging in place. Okay. So you want to, in this case, set a time limit for yourself. If you are looking for something more substantial, if not, then it may not matter all that much to you, but if it's becoming a bit routine and a bit stagnant and you guys aren't moving, but you're trying to progress into a relationship and it's not quite getting there. So let's just say you at that 6-month mark. So certain things should have been had by now. You should be further along than you were in the first few weeks and the first couple months. Okay? So you're still lingering there and it's not moving. Well, then, here's what, that is probably a sign, all right? And either that person deceived you or they just simply lied. Because when someone is looking for the same thing that you are in terms of a committed relationship, they're going to want to learn you and discover who you are. And by doing that, you're going to have to explore each other's world. That means doing different things just to see their comfort level, how they're going to act, how they're going to react. You know, you want to take people through certain phases, and the only way to do that is to be consistent with movement, moving forward, doing certain things. And that requires action. So if someone isn't giving you that, well then you may want to pause and really think about what it is that's really going on here. And then when you do that, you may pick up on or remember other little subtle signs that you kind of dismissed, but now it's all making sense. It usually makes sense at some point. However, most of us, we just tend to ignore it because it's going to get better. Once a person knows me more, they won't do those things or whatever. It'll just improve. It'll go away. No, my love. It only worsens or never improves. So yeah, that's that. Next. And I think this is, I did this video earlier in the year, I believe, talking about emotions. So many of you, you get into these connections and this person may be doing things for you, maybe taking you out, maybe cooking for you, whatever, all of these kind gestures. Gestures. What people don't seem to realize is that a gesture can be done towards anyone. Okay? Romantically or not. What you have to really expect when it comes to knowing how this person feels about you is where their emotional state is. And that is where more probing is required. So if your person says, I like you, okay, why do you like me? What do you like about me? And it can't be anything that can apply to anyone. No, I like that you're caring, that you listen to me, that you make me, when I see you, you make me want to just be alive. You know, there's something about, like they have to really go on, you make me happy. You know, there has to be certain things that is directed towards their emotions, their feelings. And they can easily express that. They can easily articulate what it is that they are feeling, which means they must be not only emotionally available, but emotionally intelligent. Because if they're just bringing you a watch or taking you to nice places, picking you up in the nice, they can do that for anyone. But what you want is to see what they're feeling towards you emotionally. I like you. Why do you like me? Okay. Why? So you want answers. Don't be afraid to ask. You never thought about why someone liked you? Usually when someone really is into you, they'll say, man, see, I like you because of this. Like they'll just come right out with it. You're so genuine. I can easily talk to you. I feel comfortable around you. Yeah, you make me just want to open up and just express myself because other people don't, you know, they articulate what it is that they can feel from you. And that's a good vibe. You know, they can actually vibe with you. And by doing so, your connection is going to grow because now that you know that, okay? And of course, in return, that has to be expressed as well. So it has to go both ways. Yeah. So, that's very important. Even when it gets to that love stage, you really want to be careful with that. Why do you love me? Well, I love you because you're a hard worker. You get the bag, you make money. No, it has to be solely about you. Not what someone else can do. Anyone can do those things, but what is it that they love about you as a person? You're gentle, you're fragile, you're sensitive. You know, things like that. Yeah, that's a big one. And a lot of people don't do that. They just hear, I love you, and never question why. Which is so ridiculous to me. You know, be more inquisitive. Don't be afraid. Hey, this is all about dating. I don't care if it's not what you don't want to hear, if they're not telling you anything that makes you feel special or just as that one individual that, hey, it's so nice to hear that from someone. If they're not giving you that, then that's probably not the right person. So you need to be able to pull out as well. Don't just stay in it thinking that this person is going to change. No, there is a process. And at a certain time, certain things need to be stated. And it needs to be heartfelt from both persons in order to progress. You see what I'm saying? So don't just assume that someone feels that way about you because they're always coming around, you're always going out. No, ask them, how do you feel about me? Don't be afraid, because I guarantee you, more so than likely, they're going to give you a bunch of BS. That's just the way it is. But now you know. Now you know what to do with that. Give it right back to them and walk away. Well, hopefully you'll do that. Yeah. Which leads me to my next thing. So when a connection doesn't, it's not giving you what it is that you need. All right. So in the beginning stages of dating, one should always state their boundaries, what they're expecting from a person, yada, yada, yada. That right there is your warning. Okay. So now you give them the chance to prove that to you, to do whatever it is that needs to be done. Next. At the end of it all, when things are not going well and you guys and someone and that person, you know, betrays you or do a disrespectful act of some kind, whatever the case may be, and you decide to let them back in, yeah, that's their second chance. So my point that I'm trying to make is that they should only get one second chance, not five. Because you've already expressed what you needed in the beginning, and now you're going to reiterate that during the second chance, okay? They may not betray you or disrespect for you in the same manner, but do something else that's even more foolish. That is when you let that go, okay? Well, how's the saying go? No one to hold them and no one to fold them? You have to. So you're not, like I said in the last video, you're not completely disappointed. Now on this, at this moment, you have the upper hand. You're letting them go. So if anyone's going to be feeling like ish at the end of the day, it'll be them. Though you may be a bit disappointed, it didn't work out, whatever, let that go. That's it. You have to learn to let it go, people. We can't keep holding on to BS, because before you know it, it's going to be everywhere. You're going to be smelling like it. You're going to turn into a BSer and put that other person onto it. It's going to become a bit hit show. I promise you. So hopefully these dating tips are going to be beneficial. I know they will, but you just have to apply them with each and every individual. Practice it, okay? Practice what you're going to say. Practice your behavior, but more so, that what's more important than anything is you have to know yourself and your boundaries in order to make this happen, and then stand firmly. Okay, my loves? Well, hopefully this has been beneficial for you. If you need further dating coaching, all of my information will be linked down below. Please subscribe so you can get this subscriber discount. It's usually discounted at like up to 50%. So you save a great deal versus those who go online to schedule their sessions. All right. So definitely subscribe. You know, you reach me either through email or however. I have different methods to reach me. And then we'll get you scheduled for the new year. You know, you could do one session or multiple. Whatever. It's on you. Okay. I thank you guys for joining me so much. That is all for now. Until next time.